My name is Teresa Frye, and my company is TechForm, Advanced Casting Technology in Portland, Oregon. I got involved in hip about 2010 when we were in the middle of a research project to really understand how platinum solidifies. And in order to do that, you look at the inside of the casting and you look at that under high magnification. What we saw in our research, we didn't like too much. There was an awful lot of porosity. I knew about the hip process because I'd spent years in the medical and aerospace industry. I wanted to see if it would do the same thing for platinum castings as it did for castings in those industries. So I got a hold of a company up in Camas, Washington, and I said, hey, can we stick some of my rings in there and see what happens? So they were very accommodating, got the castings hipped, brought them back, sectioned them, and put them under high magnification, and they were perfect. When you are creating a jewelry piece, you really need to have this pristine surface finish. And hip densifies the metal so that you have a really incredible luster and you get there quicker. So you don't have to rework as much. So from the manufacturer's perspective, you have reduced your processing time on that ring because you're working with better metal. Everything else in the manufacturing process becomes much easier, much more predictable. Typically, you'll start working on a platinum casting and you'll start revealing porosity. With the hip process, you've eliminated that porosity before you even start working on it. And it does that through heat and pressure. Hip is very effective at promoting higher ductility. And ductility is a good thing in jewelry making because, you know, imagine you want to stretch a ring up, you want to set a stone and bend that prong over. So you need a certain amount of ductility. And if you have subsurface defects in your casting, say there's a big gas pore in your prong and you go to set that prong, it's not going to be very ductile. It can crack, it can break. With the hip process, you have healed any of the subsurface pores that can make the metal less ductile. The customers love it. And the reason they love it is that they have a predictable piece of metal on their bench. So if you apply the hip process to that casting, you're not going to have to stop and rework as much. You are not going to have that cycle where you go, okay, I went to the laser, I repaired everything, I went back to the bench, I blended it, and other porosity came out in other areas. If you go too many cycles of rework, what happens is you can start losing your profiles. A lot of jewelry is very symmetrical, and so you want to make sure that those profiles are just pristine. And if you've got a lot of defects on one side and you're reworking, you can lose your profile and you can scrap that ring just because you had that porosity. And so applying hip, you're just not gonna have these issues. It's a relatively easy process to run. The expense of running it is not high. It's gonna increase your turnaround time. It's gonna increase your quality. And it's going to save you so much money in your shop. If you're a manufacturer of platinum castings and you're thinking about getting a hip unit, just do it. You will not regret it.